Okay, boys and girls, a quick demo for a fun lesson, fourth and fifth grade. This is primarily for you, but anywhere from, I think, third grade all the way up to eighth grade could have a really, really good time with this lesson because you can do it in so many different ways. Okay, let's get started. The first thing that you're going to want to do is go to this link and you'll find the Principles of Design page. Use that, open that, I should say, and read about emphasis, balance, pattern, and contrast, and then you're going to be ready to do this lesson. Okay, put that aside. The next thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to pull out your iPad, your phone, your laptop, or your imagination, one of the four, and for the digital online version, type in animal face photos and up will pop something similar to this and just scroll through until you find an animal that you really love. Now you're only going to be focusing on the eyes really, really up close on each one of these animals. So, you know, don't pick the silly ones, pick something you really like. You'll see a lot of goofy stuff. So, you know, find something that you like that means something to you. If you're going to be using your imagination, all you have to do is make sure that the eyes are the emphasis, that they're face forward. You could do, for instance, I don't know, alien eyes, superhero eyes, but the main part of this lesson is that they're going to have to be the same. Once you decide on what you're going to do, you're going to do a sketch. I didn't have any small sketch paper, but I had a note card, so I just kind of folded it over narrow and did my sketch of my owl eyes, as you can see. So once I did that, then I took out a larger piece of paper. Okay, I folded it lengthwise, hot dog fold. All of you can do this. We practice this a lot. Then what I did is I took my scissors and I cut right down this crease until I had two sheets of paper. Okay, I took one of my sheets of paper and put it aside just in case I made a mistake. Folded this one in half. Oop. Nice and half. And then I put my name down on the side, the lower front. Okay, that's where your name's going to go so I can see that it's your work. The next thing that I did was I took my sketch. I found the center. I made sure that I was working from the center out. Okay. And I drew one side at a time. Drew this, this, then I drew that and copied over here. Okay, make sure you have your eraser with you so that you can copy easily until I was done and I have this. The next thing I did was I outlined it in black. You can use black crayon like I did here, or you can use black Sharpie. If you're going to be using watercolor to do your color, you definitely want to use black Sharpie or crayon. If you're going to do everything in marker, that's fine. You can use the black Crayola marker and you won't have to worry. But if you're going to use watercolor, you do have to use a Sharpie marker, okay? Because the black Crayola will run and bleed, kind of like the lesson. Okay, after you're done doing your outline and it's nice and neat and balanced, make sure you add the contrast, the black, to your eyes. Now, when you do the highlights on the eyes, make sure that they're on the same side. Don't put one here and one here. Don't make them opposite, because if you do, your animal will look like, or your alien eyes, whatever your eyes are, they will look cross-eyed, and you kind of don't want to do that. So then when you're done with that, when you're done doing your black, then you're going to decide what you're going to color it in. Boy, that sounded weird. And if you don't have color, okay, if you want to use crayons, colored pencils, markers, watercolor, that's terrific. Whatever you want to color it in, use to color it in. You know, sometimes I don't really like to use color. And if you want, all you need is your pencil and your paper, and you can create the contrast that way. I really like using a pencil a lot because I feel like I can get a lot of texture. And you can see I just kind of use the pencil to put some texture in that way, put some texture down here, was able to shade a little bit more in my eyes. Whatever you want to do. Again, all you really need is a pencil and a piece of paper to accomplish some pretty terrific art. And here are the samples again. All of these steps and all of this information is going to be sent to you via Blooms and Google Classroom. So if you want to do this project this week, that would be wonderful. And then you can send it to me via Google Classroom or the email address on the paperwork that I sent you guys out. And have fun with it. Have a great day. Bye.